fun. Welcome to All Saints Kids. My name is Brenda and I am one of the leaders of the children's ministry here at All Saints Church in Limfield. It's great to see you today. Can we all say a big hello to our friend Janine?
Hello everybody. Hi. Hang on a minute. Normally I'm the one doing the introduction. Brenda, what's going on?
Well, today we are doing something a bit different. So I thought we should try something new.
Oh, okay, I see. So what's special about today?
Today is Mission Sunday. Janine, can you tell all the people watching at home what mission is?
Of course I can, Brenda. You see, everybody at home, do you remember? Before Jesus went back to heaven, he told his disciples, go and tell the whole world about who I am. You see, that's what going on mission means. It means you might leave the country where you live. If you're in England right now, this is where we live. You might travel across the world to a different country. Perhaps a country where they speak a different language or eat different food to what we expect to be eating. You see, you're going there to tell people about who Jesus is. And they may have never heard of Jesus or the Bible, but we want to tell them because we know that if we know who Jesus is and we trust him, that we can be saved and be with him forever. It's the best news, isn't it? Well, today joining us for our video is somebody called Steve Smith, and he is from Serving in Mission UK. You see, groups of people get together to support people who go and tell about Jesus all over the world. And Serving in Mission UK is one of those. And he's going to talk to us today about what it means to be a missionary.
That's right, Janine. I can't wait to learn more about mission. But Janine, how should we start today?
Well, I think we should start today with a song. Let's have a song that tells us that we can trust in God's word. So why don't you find a space and let's sing together, and we'll see you in a few minutes.
Built the most enormous boats. They kept the birds and animals afloat. The Lord was good, the Lord was strong, you know, the world lived beside him. Moses led his people through the sea, taking them away from slavery. The Lord was good, the Lord was strong, and Moses lived his life for him. Oh, thank you, oh, thank you, that all through history you were faithful. Thank you, oh, thank you, that you are just the same when it comes to me. When it comes to me. David fought Goliath and he won. A humble shepherd boy became a king. The Lord was good, the Lord was strong, and David lived his life for him. Daniel was inside a lion's den, but God brought him to safety once again. The Lord was good, the Lord was strong, and Daniel lived his life for him. Oh, thank you, oh, thank you, that all through history you were faithful. Thank you, oh, thank you, that you are just the same when it comes to me. When it comes to me. Jesus died to take away our sins, so we could get to know our God again.
The Lord is good, the Lord is strong, and we will live our lives to Him.
Well done, everyone. Now, everyone at home, in the description section of this video, there is a link to a craft that you can print off and do at home. You can pause the video now and join in as Steve teaches us from the Bible, or you can watch the talk now and do the craft later.
Well, it's great to be with you today, and even though we can't all be together in person, we can all together do an activity that helps us understand what it means when God smiles on us in Jesus. Can you do a smile? It's a wonderful thing to receive a smile, isn't it? But when we say God smiles on us in Jesus, we're saying He blesses us. He gives us things. When we place our trust in Jesus, He gives us everything we need for life and to live for Him. And we're going to see how He does that now in using this activity. Now, hopefully you received a passport in your craft box, and in there you've also got three stickers. One sticker says adopted, one says forgiven, and one says inherit. We're going to see exactly what that means right now. So when I got my daughter to fill in my passport, it's a great likeness, don't you think? I'll be remembering this and keeping that one safe. But if you fill in your picture, if you haven't done so already, do it later. Put your face on that and open this up now. And we're going to make a few little things here to show what it means that God smiles on us when He blesses us in Jesus. And the first thing we want to see is that He gives us a whole new family. It means that I can say, if I've trusted in Jesus, I am a child of God. We're going to write that down now. It says, I am a child of God. I'm going to take our sticker, and it's the adopted sticker, and we're going to put it there in the passport, stamped, adopted. But what does that mean? Well, naturally, we're all born with a mum and dad. I could show you a picture of mine now, and you'll, and we all have people who are our natural parents. But we're not born natural children of God. But what we learn in Ephesians 1 is that we're told that He predestined us for adoption. That's the Bible's way of saying He decided before we were born to say, you will be my child. That means that God welcomes us as one of His children. And that's what happens when we come into His loving arms and we say, I trust you. I love you and thank you for showing me who you are in Jesus. And God says, now I know you as my child. You are mine. And what's mine is yours. We can always come to God as our Father, knowing that He's a good Father. In Jesus, we know that He knows our needs. He loves to give us good gifts. And what's more, He knows what's best for you and for me. So we join a whole new family. That's the first thing. We're adopted. He says, you are now in my family. He doesn't say you're not in your own family. We stay in our families. But he said, you're part of a whole new family, the family of God. That's the first thing. Second thing is that he gives us a new status. Now, what does that mean? It means that I can write here, I am forgiven. Forgiven. And there's a stamp for that. The red stamp says forgiven. And in chapter 1, verse 7, it says, in him, that's Jesus, we have the forgiveness of sins. And when we do things or think things or say things that build up wrong in friendships, they damage friendships, don't they? We kind of build a wall through the things that we do wrong. When we say things or think things or do things that just don't please the people and actually cause them hurt. But with God, we do things that don't please him. We don't love him or our friends or our neighbours as ourselves. And we don't think things that please him. We think bad things about our friends or our brother and sister or our mum and dad or whoever's around. And actually we say things that just really hurt and harm. And it builds up a wall, a relationship, a barrier to that relationship. And the older you get, believe you me, the bigger the wall gets. But what God says in Jesus is, I forgive you. That's to say, Jesus is the only one who doesn't add to the wall. He doesn't have a wall between him and God. But he comes, is born into the world, and he takes away every wrong. He pays the price for it. He dies a death that he doesn't deserve. Saying, I take away every one of your wrongs, and God says, I forgive you. They no longer are counted in our relationship. They're gone now. Jesus has taken them away. What good news that is. The way is clear into a relationship with God. When we come into God's loving arms, he says, there's nothing between us now. Even though you did wrong, Jesus has taken it away. He's paid the price. I love you. My love for you is greater than the wrongs you have done. I've paid for it all. I've paid it all. We're friends now. And that's the second benefit. We're friends with God. We are forgiven. But hang on, there's a third thing here. We have a new destination. And that's where this word inherit comes. You put that in the stamp, you will inherit. You can write, I will inherit. But what does that mean? My auntie Sheila, she died. It was really sad. We really miss her. But she left us something that she had as an inheritance. She wrote a letter and she said, this is yours now. I leave it to you. It's yours. That's an inheritance. When we receive something from someone else who says, what's mine is now yours. And in Jesus, God gives us an inheritance. We inherit not just someone's property or something they got. We inherit a whole new creation, a whole new world, a world made new, not damaged by the things we've done, but made new by God. He says, that will be yours. And in chapter 1, verse 14, it says that the Holy Spirit is a deposit guaranteeing our inheritance. And that means that he gives us his spirit now to say this will definitely happen in the future. We can be sure that he will make the world new because of the presence of his spirit drawing us to faith in Jesus and giving us the power to live for him in this world. It's such good news. That's why we can say, I'm a child of God, I am forgiven, and I will inherit. And we long for many more people around the world to hear this news so they can say, they are a child of God, they are forgiven, they will inherit this whole new world with us. So I want to invite you to pray with your families, to pray for these people. And there's something called Sim Pray Kids, your parents can look up, to pray for those families who are doing this around the world, sharing in communities where Jesus is least known. So more people can say they are God's children adopted, they are forgiven, and they can join us in the new creation that we will inherit. That's great news, and we want many more people to enjoy that with us in Jesus. Thanks for listening. God bless you.
Wow, that was amazing. I'm a child of God. I am adopted, forgiven, and I inherit from Jesus. It's amazing.
That's right, Brenda. It is amazing. We are called to go and tell people about who Jesus is. And Steve did such a great job teaching us what that looks like. Now, we're really lucky today because at All Saints, we have our mission partners with us, Jonny and Olga. They're the Anderson family, and they are on mission in Bolivia, and they've come home for a little while. And they're going to share with us a little bit about what life is like as a family on mission. Now, Johnny's going to talk to us through this next video with some pictures. So listen out for his questions and see if you can answer them before he gives you the answer. And we'll see you in a few minutes.
Hello, we are the Andersons and we normally live and work in Bolivia. And I've got a few slides to show you about God's adopted family in Bolivia. And I was wondering if you could help me answer them. So, here for my first question. Are you ready? In Bolivia, we work with just old people or young people? What do you think? Well, God's adopted family is amongst old people like in this picture, but it's also amongst young people. Next question. Are God's adopted people, do we call them from the countryside or from the town? You can see these fellows are from the countryside, but here's our neighbour in the town as well, who we're trying to reach for Jesus. Are we working amongst God's adoptive people, as who are our friends, people we know? Yes, you can see here. Here are some of our friends. But also, we want to meet strangers and tell them how God can forgive them as well. And the next question is, are we working with God's adoptive people who are just pastors? Or church members as well. Yes, these guys are pastors, but here too are church members that we also work with. Next question. Are we working with people who we want to see forgiven and become adopted in God's family? Yes, these are our friends from our squash club. But also here, these are our friends who are already part of God's adopted family in the church. And is it just the adults that teach in God's adopted family, or can children teach too? Look, this child's teaching the other children, but also we help the adults to teach too, like this pastor here. And do we just teach using stories? No, not just stories. What are we doing here? He's whipping him, because this is a drama about Jesus being crucified. But we also do crafts, like you guys do as well. So you can see that through whatever means and by in all different places in Bolivia, we're trying to reach God's people and those outside the church so they can also be forgiven and adopted into God's family.
Well, wasn't that amazing? It's so interesting seeing what life is like on mission. I think that this is a great time to pray. Now, we are going to pray, but I want to draw your attention to a link in the description of this video. Now, Sim, Serving in Mission UK, have got an amazing thing called Sim Kids, and it's for praying together. So do follow that link, and as a family, spend some time praying about world mission and for those who are out spreading the good news. But for right now, why don't we have our wiggly fingers? Very good. And our washing machine hands. Get faster and faster and clap. Heavenly Father, Lord, thank you that we are adopted into your family, that we are forgiven by you, and that we are inheriting your love, your grace. Lord, as we seek to tell people about Jesus, please, Lord, help us to be bold, give us courage. And Lord, we pray for those who are already on mission all around the world in different countries. Lord, we pray that you will protect them, that you will give them wisdom and guidance as they live their life in a different place from home. Lord, we pray that your word is spread throughout the whole world so that people can be saved and come to know you and be part of your family. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, 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 amen. I agree, amen. Well done, everybody. So before we go today, we're going to have some notices. Brenda, is there anything we need to know? Brenda? Brenda?
Baby shark, do 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 do. Baby shark, do 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 do. Oh, I just love singing so much. I wish I could sing all the time.
Well, actually, I have some good news for you. I wonder at home, do you love singing too? I do. So really exciting news. All Saints wants to launch a children's choir and we want you to be part of it. Now, if you love singing and you're happy to stand up and sing with our congregation, then Chris Stainer will be holding a special morning on the 26th of June. Now, if you are able to come to that morning to hear about what the music ministry is going to look like this coming year, that would be brilliant. Do sign up. There's a link here. Do sign up so that Chris knows you're coming. Now, if you're not able to come to that morning, but you'd still be interested to know about what the ministry is doing, whether that's children's choir or other things, then there is an option on that link that says, I can't come, but do let me know what's happening. So do sign up for that as well.
It was so lovely to see you all today. Remember to keep praying for your brothers and sisters around the world. Now, it's time to snuggle up with a teddy, adult or pillow, and let's sing our last song for today. Until next week, it's goodbye from me. Bye! And goodbye from Janine.
Goodbye.
Yeah.